Okay, I know that I have personally two basic steps, which one I showed you is the walking step, which has 2, 3, 4 sounds options, and the other is the Buckdance basic step, the N01, which works to me best in taps, but I've shown you can do it in leather. There's a third basic step. It's not my basic step. It is used by flatfoot dancers and buck dancers, but it does not have a chug in it. That's why I'm showing it to you, because I think there are people who are discouraged by the athleticism required of that chug step. But it's at a cost, because you know that chug up and down movement gives you a momentum that allows you to make better quality sounds. But I'm going to show you a heel-toe option. Heel-toe step option that I see Evie Ladin use in her DVD. Although mine broke and I only got to watch it once or twice. So I think this is what a lot of people do, and it's a less athletic. So I'm just going to try my best to show that here. Heel-toe step. Heel toe step, heel toe step, heel toe step. The hard part that I have is at high speeds. So let's just do the basic step, which you remember is just step, rock, step. It's really usually done only once on one side. Unless you're doing another step, like cloggers do a shuffle in between, then you go to the other foot. Step, rock, step. Step, rock, step. Step, rock, step. That's called a basic. Now on that, you can add this heel, toe, step. Rock, step. Heel, toe, step. Rock, step. Heel, toe, step. Rock, step. From the back. Yeah, so I'm going to contrast that with a three sound walking step, which has two sound on one side. Because that's how I would make a parallel. You could make the comparison. Yeah, I'm doing a three sound and a rock step. So three sound on one side and then a rock step. Way to do that is a three sound on one side and a two sound on the other. So that's how you get the da 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 da. Ways of getting the same sound. This particular heel toe step allows you to do it without as much. That's what's so tiring for people, that chug. But you know, it doesn't have to be a big chug. That back chug doesn't have to be that big. But anyway, for the moment, let me focus on doing this heel toe step rock step with the basic in a circle. So try this along with me. It's really useful to know, especially if you have tap shoes. My problem with it is at high Okay, and so then the way you get the flat footers Alamo sound is you do three of these singles in a row. And then you do a rock step. So starting on the left. Going in a circle already. That forward momentum kind of helps me a little bit. Because standing in place, I don't get a lot of momentum. Neither up or down or... Like I said, it's doable in taps. So much is doable in taps. Doesn't require as much momentum to get the same sound. Missed a toe there. Yeah, anyway, this is not my basic step. It's just, it is a flatfooter's basic step, and one that's very, people with knee problems might prefer this. And it's, in general, a good way, is still good practice, because you'll build up lower leg strength and ankle strength, and then you'll be able to do, if you don't have knee problems, you'll be able to do the build up to the walking step if you can't already do it. So I'm going to do this to a little bit of music, and I'll play something from my favorite band, Georgia Crackers. This song is called Diamond Joe. Let's see if it works for dancing.